yo, this your boy Mike Ricks, man. We're partner DJ. Let them know you here.
This your boy DJ.
Hey, man, we giving y'all a live reaction to the NFC South picks, man. You know, the NFC South here, but we versus the NFL. So the pick is in for the Los Angeles Chargers. And guess who's on deck? The Carolina Panthers, baby. Let's get it, man. We don't know who they got yet. But I want to say this, Carolina Nation. Panther Nation, Simmons is still on the board as of right now. Derrick Brown is still on the board right now. We got options. We can trade back. We can take one of those two if the Chargers don't pick it. So, we'll see. We will see who they get. Now, I'm interested with this pick because if the Los Angeles Chargers do not draft a quarterback right now, I am a big believer that Cameron Jarrell Newton will be in Los Angeles.
Yeah, it'll be interesting to see. But the other direction they're going to go is, what, tackle? I mean.
Right.
Let's see.
Let's see. I mean, it makes sense, though, man. If looking at their roster, they got Terrell, who's $7 million. If they get the rookie contract there, then they have that option if they go Herbert. But, well, who knows? Who knows? I think they got a plan, and we will see. The pick is going to be in. Who are they getting? Well, Cam, you're not going to Los Angeles.
Find somewhere else.
Maybe Jacksonville if Jameis don't get there. Hey, he's from Oregon. That's the LA market. He's not going too far from home.
And let's be real about it. I mean, an offensive tackle going to LA is not exciting going to LA right now.
Absolutely not.
Quarterback is what you want to do coming to a new city trying to attract people. I mean, it just makes sense.
Yeah, absolutely.
A lot of people over there watched him play because he played in Oregon. So, right. You know, it's a familiar face. So, you know, makes sense. Makes a lot of sense.
All right. Well, game time. Simmons is on the board. Simmons is on the freaking board.
Watch out, go Derrick Brown. Y'all go Derrick Brown.
Even if it is Derrick Brown, I'm okay with that. We both have – I'm okay with either one of those picks.
That's but true. I mean, let's talk about them then. All right, so we got Isaiah Simmons and Derrick Brown on the board, right?
Right.
So how – I guess, what impact would each one bring in a different way if they were selected for the Panthers?
All right, so I think Derrick Brown is an instant starter. I'm not saying both of them are, but he provides an instant need right now. We have nobody that's next to KK. For the right now immediate need, probably Derrick Brown is the better pick. But if we're looking for overall future of this team, I think Simmons is the way to go.
I think Brown, he's going to give your defensive coordinator a lot of position flexibility on that defensive line. He played outside, he played inside. I mean, he can rush the quarterback from different directions. I mean, he is, in my opinion, this is the closest thing we've seen to Aaron Donald in the draft since Aaron Donald. He's not Aaron Donald yet, but I mean, just his ability to rush the passer different ways, his first step is impressive. It's not as fast as Donald, but it's definitely impressive. Now, Isaiah Simmons, what's up with that one?
Yeah.
What you think about Isaiah Simmons? Give me that.
Hey, man. Like I said, we both, oh, of course, it want to act up now that we talking about Oh, here we go. There we go. Hey, I think Simmons is a Pro Bowl, all pro, changing the game. Derwin James, Honey Badger.
Sean Taylor.
Yeah, Sean Taylor. He is that mold. Now, I know he talked about linebacker and he was classified as a linebacker, but I will say this, man. He loves coverage and getting his hands on the ball. He mentioned that a lot on his interview. So, I think it's a great, great move because he can play safety, linebacker, nickel, outside rusher, everything. So it's somebody that can stay on the field all down. So the Carolina Panthers, the pick is in. The pick is in. We're waiting for these TV timeouts, as you see. We got the commercials right there. They want to do the commercials for my team. So, oh, this is nerve-wracking. This is nerve-wracking. I'm putting my phone away. Baby, take my phone. Say, baby, take my phone. I got my right hand next to me. You see, this is my right hand right here. I got my right hand next to me.
As that, my right hand just came in here to talk junk because I got my jersey on and my hat on.
Right, we both married men, man, so that's what they do to us. We love them.
She put me on FaceTime and try to clown me. It's all good, though.
Yeah, so.
She don't get it.
Yeah, man. So I do want to say this, man. I called in on the show, Panther Nation. Make sure you like, subscribe, share, comment, all that good stuff, man. I do want to give a shout out to Mr. Big Cat, Keep Pounding TV. He does a lot of live shows. He does a lot of content for the Carolina Panthers. He's very animated. I think he's a good watch. He has a couple guys, Quan, shout out to you. I called in a couple nights ago on his show and spoke on who I think the Carolina Panthers are going to get and why. DJ, you and I have had offline comments about it. And since the comments were pretty much talking about the coaching staff being college coaches and all of that, and so they're probably going to want to recruit the most talented and athletic player in this draft. And my opinion as of right now, it looks like Isaiah Simmons is that guy left on it. So I would not be surprised if this is the pick. But
the reason why Isaiah Simmons should be the pick, because his positional flexibility, and I'm not going to say he can mask a lot of things that the Panthers can't do right now, but he masks a lot of things that, you know, he can bring a lot to that defense. If you're lacking in certain areas, he can cover it. I mean, he offers a lot. It makes a lot of sense if Isaiah Simmons is the pick here. It makes a lot of sense if Derrick Brown's the pick. Y'all literally can't go wrong with this pick.
I think so. Unless we go tackle.
I would laugh. Y'all would hear a live laugh. I mean, this.
Look, y'all. If we go tackle, I might get a little out of character. We see you, C-Mac. We see you, C-Mac. C-Mac Mizzle with the sizzle.
Maybe they should go tackle a block for that man.
Missing $16 million.
Sorry, you got here to have my daughter in the background.
Yeah. Don't worry, I got my kids here too, man. They washing dishes.
This is live as it's going to come, folks.
Yeah, this is real live. Look here. Listen, they fussing probably. Look, my 4-year-old had about – how many ice did he have, baby? 5 or 6, and talking about he want horns now. So now he trying to get another one. Like it ain't 9 o'clock. Hey, that's it, Jew. No more. Yeah. Hey, Landon, don't you say one word. I'm recording. It's behind. I gotta say that disclaimer. I'm sorry, y'all. Because he'll tell it. He will definitely tell it. So this pick is in. So who are we going to get? Simmons or Brown? Simmons or Brown? Simmons or Brown? Marty Herney was very high on Brown, though. I can tell that. He did go to the pro day, so let's see who's going to get. I think Simmons is the way, though. Let's hit a pick. Derrick Brown, defensive tackle. Hey, I ain't mad at all at this one.
Derrick Brown, I ain't want to say it before we started, was definitely the safer pick.
Absolutely.
When you're trying to build a foundation, a franchise, I mean, you want to build from the inside out, right? So, right. Picking a player like Derrick Brown on that line, you got him for the next 5 years. You know what you're getting. You're getting a high motor kid. Like I said, positional flexibility. I mean, he beats his man in front of him in the run and the pass. I mean, very good player. Very good player. Makes a lot of sense. Right.
And DJ will tell you, we've been mocking since January, right? Because our teams weren't in the playoffs and anything. So I've been mocking since January. I would say 90%, if not more, of my mocks had who at the seventh pick.
Oh, it's been Derrick Brown. I mean, we've been playing out the Derrick Brown scenario for the longest because he made the most sense.
Right.
Isaiah Simmons has been a late riser because of what he can do and what he could be, which that's a risky pick, but a pick that can pay off. But, I mean, like you said, building a new organization, which they're trying to do in Carolina, Derrick Brown is the pick that you know, the surefire. It's just,
yeah,
that's your Reggie White. You know, that's your Reggie White. That's your Leroy Salmon. That's your, I'm saying, you're trying to start over. Like, it's just, that's what you're going to do.
Like, look at this, guys. I mean, we're looking at film here. Derrick Brown just is an animal, man. He causes problems with anybody who he played against. Like, look, kid, come here. He's good. I mean, against the run, pass rush, he destroys. He takes on double teams like nothing. I mean, he's done this against LSU, Alabama. You're talking about the cream of the crop teams. So. Come here.
Derrick Brown.
You see it? That's what we got, Carolina. We got that to go with KK and Brian Burns. And trust, we're not done in this draft. And I told you I like to say it's corners a lot in the second and third round. So I think that's where we go next. Second round pick tomorrow night. I'm saying it right now. I'm giving y'all a little spoiler. Carolina Panthers draft a corner. Probably because we ain't got nobody else on the roster anyway, so it only makes sense.
Right, and it means it matters how the board falls. I mean, there can be a run on corners this first day. I mean, it makes the most sense to go that direction, but we'll see.
It could. I like him a lot, man. I'm actually really good with the pick, man. Panther Nation, make sure y'all like, comment. Let us know what you think about the pick. I'm all in it, man. I love it. I mean, you're talking about unanimous first team All-American. SEC Defensive Player of the Year. Come on, y'all.
I mean, yeah. I mean, there's nothing really. Uh-oh, my daughter's trying to give me some. Oh, she's like, yeah, so. He's just all everything on that defensive line. Like you said, KK is getting older. If you just listen, you know, you just don't know what you're going to do with him.
Right.
The future, Derrick Brown's the future of that team, and he's going to be there for a while.
Absolutely.
We're going to be back.
Yeah, man. We're going to be back.
Tampa Bay Buccaneers.
Tampa Bay. Hey, I want to leave y'all with this last comment, though. Keep pounding.
We're going to fire the cannon when we get back.
Oh, Derrick Brown, baby. It don't even got the same ring as my cam. Hey, but shout out to the Cardinals for getting Isaiah Simmons. But yeah, man, we will be back. We will be back to make sure we touch on Tampa Bay Buccaneers. So
and
we
the Falcons.
Going to go through this entire draft. It's just a lot of dead air. So be prepared. He plays slot corner. He plays outside linebacker. He plays corner.
on the move.
Yeah, man.
Where we at?
Yo, we are. The Las Vegas Raiders have the 12th pick, and their pick is in. So we want to kind of, since we left off from the Carolina Panthers selecting Derrick Brown, Isaiah Simmons went to the Arizona Cardinals, C.J. Henderson to the Jacksonville Jags. Great pickup, in my opinion. Jerick Wills, your boy, DJ, went to the Browns. Yes.
Another reason they hate the Browns. Another reason. That's why I ain't going to the playoffs this year.
Mekhi Becton ended up going to the Jets. So now you're down. You only got two picks in front of you. And all you have left is Wirfs or whatever his name is.
Oh, he's coming home. He's coming home. Come on, Christian.
We going to see because I believe the Raiders and the 49ers are getting receivers.
Well, right, right. No, I agree with you there. So they had to get in front of probably the Broncos to get this wide receiver.
Right.
Because the Broncos need a receiver to help out little old Drew Locke, who's the future John Elway in the Broncos psych. But that's what they believe.
Oh, no, I'm getting some sugar from the wife, man. She about to go lay down. So. Oh,
that's so cute. See, people, this is live, baby. I mean, you see it. Family, you see it every day right now. You know what I'm saying?
Right. Absolutely. So, man, you're absolutely right, man. Oh, wow. The pick is in, y'all. The Las Vegas Raiders have selected Henry Ruggs. This does not surprise. This is a Gruden pick.
It's the speed. I mean, who was the owner that passed on this team? He took it to
the who was the what?
And when the owner of this team used to be.
Yeah, you're right. You're right.
Speed. These mugs love speed. They love speed over talent. There's no speed to take CeeDee Lamb. I mean, Ruggs over CeeDee Lamb. I'm sorry. I mean.
Yeah, I don't.
That's a mistake. Ruggs is going to be good, but guess what? CeeDee Lamb's going to be great. You know what I'm saying? So I'm not doing that.
His honor, throwing up that three every time.
I don't know. So to me, now you let the 49ers go get.
Woo! Debo Samuels, CeeDee Lamb.
If you want to talk about that one, my God, watch what Henry Ruggs did.
Right, Kittle. Then that slew of running backs.
Slew of obliteration. He was jumping.
Never got to be the pick here. I'm sorry. I mean, if they pick my offensive lineman, first of all, I'm going to hate the 49ers first day of life. I'm going to say that first. And then second, what are y'all doing? Y'all really trying to set up Jimmy to suck next year?
Set up who to suck?
If they didn't go wide receiver here, because Jimmy need another wide receiver.
Yeah, and they got rid of Emmanuel Sanders. I mean, they didn't get rid of him, but, you know, he was gone. He didn't
go. Yeah.
Right, he didn't resign. So that's why you have to, in my opinion. You have to make this move.
Right. Right. And they better make this pick, or we're going to have problems. We're going to have problems.
Yeah.
Now the Raiders will be on the C.J. Henderson. I thought he was a really good corner. But wow, I was shocked with the Jags taking him, man.
Really? I wasn't. I'm telling you, I've been hearing a lot of rumbles that this C.J. Henderson could potentially be the best corner in this draft NFL-wise. I know coming out, Jeff Okuda is the guy, but what I've been hearing... Hey, who knows?
I mean, he was one of the better man coverage corners. I mean, you lost Ramsey, so I mean, it makes sense. I'm still a little shocked.
And they lost AJ Bouye. He's gone too.
Okay, right. And they also lost they lost their edge rusher too. What's his name?
Tremendous running.
Don't judge me, y'all. That African guy.
No, but they still have him on the roster. He ain't gone yet.
Oh, he ain't gone yet, but he went out.
Yeah, he wants out.
He probably ain't going nowhere then. Never mind.
Right.
He ain't going nowhere. When you start talking but you can't get out, you ain't going nowhere.
No.
And look, we was talking to Mike
Mayock. So, I can see why. It seemed like he may have been a little reached. Kinlaw was a lot on most people's mock for them. But from what I see, man, I don't know if Kinlaw is as good as what people say he is. I got to see it. I think he has a lot to play for. But I don't know.
I mean, he was South Carolina boy. I mean, you talk about Clowney not living up to what Clowney should have been when he came out.
Yeah,
that's
like not. Yeah, you hate on South Carolina.
You a South Carolina head?
Yeah.
I mean, little jab in there. Little jab.
Yo, why is this taking forever, man?
We didn't expect this to be this long. Uh-oh, I feel a little bit. But we didn't expect it to be this long, so we try to fill a little bit of dead air.
Listen, right. Just a little bit, but we good, man. We good. I really like the direction the draft is going. It's very interesting. Very interesting. So I am very shocked that Henry Ruggs came out before Judy. But when you're talking about athletes, this guy is, he's a freak. Have a track star, was a heck of an athlete, can jump out of the gym in basketball. I seen highlights of him booming on people left and right just now. So, hey.
Once again, this is a John Gruden pick. I mean,
yeah.
You want to talk about overdrafting players. Like I said, this doesn't mean Ruggs can't be a good player, but John Gruden is notorious for overdrafting players. I mean, he did it so many times. He set the Bucs back because of the way he drafted. He let players like Aaron Rodgers go.
Breaking news. Tampa Bay just moved up and traded to the San Francisco 49ers to swap picks.
What?
49ers trade pick to the Bucs. So the Bucs move up one spot to go get this offensive lineman. Now you know they weren't going to draft this offensive lineman.
Right. So all they did was acquire another pick.
Right.
For what they did when they knew they weren't doing it in the first place. So
right.
That tells me that there was teams calling up to the 49ers possibly coming to get Tristan Wirfs.
That's exactly what was going on. And because John Lynch, even though they did him dirty, John Lynch probably was like, you know what? Tampa, I'm telling you right now, this is what's going to go down. So I'm going to give you a little nod so you can make the move.
He in the ring of honor. He a buck. At the end of the day, John Lynch is a buck, okay?
Right.
He can win to Denver. He could be San Francisco's GM. He a buck.
Tristan Wirfs. I guarantee you it's Tristan Wirfs.
It better be. Shit. I know.
You good. We see on here. This is just a lie. It better be.
Because
if
I'm serious about that.
If I wouldn't have got Derrick Brown or Simmons, you would have heard some stuff. Hey, look at Mr. Kango. Oh, you can't see, but Mr. Kango right now on the phone. Talking to somebody.
He got to protect Tom. Maybe still terrific.
Yeah, Bruce Arians in chill mode. Got his shorts on with his buff gear, polo, and his Kango hat. Looks very Bruce Arians-like right now.
When I say this man has, like, learned how to chill, period, I mean, Leftwich being off as a coordinator. I mean, he brought in Tom Brady to probably help him, you know, call him plays too. I mean, he's in beyond chill mode. He's not in the alpha male. I want to take over everything.
Right. So, the Tampa Bay Buccaneers draft CeeDee Lamb. No, I'm just playing.
I wouldn't be mad about that either.
I know that would not be fair. That's a cheat code. So Wolves can go left and right.
Right, he has a lot of flexibility. He's probably, in my opinion, Andrew Thomas might have been the most pro ready. Wolves, he has the most positional flexibility, and just he's the biggest athlete. I mean, he's just, I think he got the highest ceiling. I think him and Wills, in my opinion, had the highest ceiling. I want either one of them for a long time. I mean, and I'm getting one of them, it seems like. So, I'm cool with it.
What if y'all mess around and draft a Kinlaw?
What was my first mock ever?
Yeah, I know.
It won't happen because you got Tom Brady here. If Jameis Winston was here, they might have got Kinlaw.
They're not gonna give him the offensive line help.
Nah, they probably have to see the same way and told him to go out there and play.
Run, Jameis, run.
They ain't gonna do Tom Brady like that though. They're gonna make sure they take care of Tom.
Right. So the pick is in. The pick is in. The 13th pick. And that's your guy, Tristan Wirfs.
Welcome home, big boy. Let's go.
Welcome home. Where is he from?
I don't care where he's from, but where he is Tampa.
Welcome home. You saying it like you.
Welcome home, my brother. Welcome home.
Oh, he ran a faster 40 times than Joey Bosa.
Yes, he's the most athletic tackle in this draft. You ain't seen a video where he jumped out the pool like he was box jumping?
That's right, yeah.
That kid is athletic. And his kick step to his mirroring skills is ridiculous. I think he's not a power scheme blocker. He's a better zone read blocker when it comes to, like, you know, them cuts and stuff like that. So, obviously, we're probably moving more to a zone read, you know, scheme when it comes to running. You got a very, you know, athletic line. I mean, across the board, you got Donovan Smith. Everybody, he's very athletic. Ali Marpet, very athletic. Brian Jensen, very athletic. A little more power, but he has athleticism to get to the second level. Alex Kappa used to be a tackle, so I'm assuming he's athletic. So, I mean, now you add in Tristan on the right side. Let's go. Let's go.
Oh, here you go. You're about to jump out this pool.
Look at your face. Yep. That boy is an athlete, boy.
So I know we got some guys. Like, I'm a big Brian Burns fan. You get somebody that's over there that can move and manhandle people. Gosh. Yeah, he plays a really good leverage, man.
Oh, yeah, I really like this kid. I mean, I think he is as advertised.
Dang.
Very excited.
Yeah.
I just can't believe we traded up for it, though. Oh, my God. What we give up for that?
That I don't know. You have to do your own research on. I don't care that much about the Bucks.
You better this year, because we going to be whooping that ass.
No, you're not. Nah. So, I'm curious to see what the trade was. There's so much is going on.
A little transitioning here, people. I hope I'm not on there.
Yeah, man. So we got the Bucks. So we'll be coming back shortly with the Atlanta Falcons, man. So that's up the 16th pick. Yes, sir. Stay tuned. So we have the Atlanta Falcons coming up. We got, you know, Tampa Bay. We're going to recap that a little bit. DJ, who y'all pick up as a 13th pick since y'all want to trade up for the 49ers again?
Man, all I'm going to say is before I say who we got, they must have got some intel saying that somebody was coming, or San Francisco. I think John Lynch might have just pulled a little cord. He might have been like, hey, we got somebody coming up saying they might want this offensive tackle. Y'all want him?
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Like, I might have to just, you know, switch with us because we got a call coming through about your pick that is now Tampa Bay Buccaneers, which is Tristan Wirfs. Very happy with this pick. Jedrick Wills was my first offensive lineman that I wanted. Wills was number two. So I'm very happy that we got him. Not happy. Like, I got to see what we traded away to get up one pick. It should have been too deep. It might have been like a fourth, third. I hope it's like only like a third or fourth, maybe even better, maybe a fifth. I don't know. But yeah, man, you know what you're getting. You're getting definitely one of the more athletic, or is the most athletic offensive tackle coming out. I think he ran like a 4.8, 40 or something like that.
Right.
As fast as can be. Technician. Very good pass sets. Good against the run. Very good hand placement. Very good leverage. Doesn't get off balance a lot. I mean, like I said, I like this kid a lot. He definitely now adds some youth to our offensive line that needed in the place of DeMar Dotson. I mean, this line is pretty now secure for Mr. Tom Brady. So, let's go. I like it.
Right. So, hey, I think it's a great pick for y'all, man. So, we got the 49ers that came next, and they drafted defensive tackle Javon Kinlaw from South Carolina. They lost Buckner to the Colts. So, and I forgot, that's how they got that pick. They traded Buckner and got the Colts' first-round pick.
What does that tell you? They didn't want to pay them. They want to get younger because they got already 1,000 picks on that damn line.
That's right. So now they got more. So now they go keep that same line under the rookie contracts with talent and some dogs, which is smart, man. They can't pay everybody on that line. So now up is the Denver Broncos. They selected Jerry Jeudy. In my opinion, I think that's
showing up. But
it's in already. I refreshed it multiple times. You know, NFL Network, I don't know what you got going on, but it didn't show up. It hasn't updated yet. So that's who the pick is. And to me, I thought that was the best receiver in this draft. I know DJ thinks, and most people think Lamb is, but I'm a route guy. So that stands out to me. He's probably the best route runner I've seen coming out of college. And that's saying a lot because I watched a lot of wide receivers. So, in a long, long time. It's a great move.
I agree with you. So I mentioned this with you. I said Jerry Jeudy definitely has the cleanest routes.
Yeah, you did.
All receivers coming out. The only thing, it's not really a knock. He just played with some hell of receivers around him. You know, these are all, you know, three players are going in the top.
Right.
So, you know, he's going to be now by himself in Denver because what else they got out there as a receiver, really?
Good question. I don't think they're by themselves, man. They got,
Thank you. So, I mean, that's what I'm saying. So, I mean, it's not that he can't do it because obviously, I mean – his production speaks for itself, you know, in Alabama. And everybody knew who the guy was, which was him.
Right.
So, you know, it's not really a knock. It's just, we'll see. Let's just say that, you know.
Yeah.
But he's definitely a good pick. Drew Lock needs a receiver. If they really believe in him, that's a good pick.
Right. So now, if you're looking at this board, who's left for the Atlanta Falcons? Since this is NFC South, let's talk about it a little bit. Chaseon is still out there. I think that's a great pick for him. AJ, what's his name? AJ Terrell is still out there. That could be a potential good pick for them. Suggs from Alabama, another corner, because they need a corner and a pass rusher and an edge. So Well, wait, where you think they DJ?
I think the Atlanta Falcons probably pissed in their pants a little bit when they saw C.J. Henderson leave so early. I think they probably would have moved to go get him if he made it a little further.
Right.
Because I think that probably would have been a player they would have wanted to go get. I do think A.J. Terrell is definitely in their minds. Somebody you ain't mentioned. It's the NFC South, dog. CeeDee Lamb is in play, dog. CeeDee Lamb is in play. I'm sorry.
No.
Like, he's in play. You just let go of your tight end. You still got Julio getting older, who doesn't play all the snaps all the time. And you got Calvin Ridley, who's been hurt the last 2 years.
Well, you know Atlanta. Atlanta is known to draft receivers.
Right. So that's what I'm saying. He's in play. I mean, what would make sense is Chaseon. I mean, Chaseon come off the edge. They haven't had any type of a real consistent edge rush in a long time. I know they just got Dante Fowler, but, you know, he's moving up from team to team right now. You know, he can't even stay on the team right now. I mean, he's a good player. But
yeah. I think this is going to be interesting, man. You never know with them. They can always go receiver. Like, they went, in my opinion, I didn't think they needed Calvin Ridley first round, but guess what they did? They went Calvin Ridley first round. So,
look, they just saw what the Tampa Bay Buccaneers, my team, just did and what we got going on out here. So, the firepower, they're going to want to bring more firepower to that offense. Like I said, Kinlaw's gone. Henderson, I guarantee, was high on their board. A.J. Terrell's going to be a nice little piece, but maybe a little rich at 16. I don't know.
Well, maybe that might be. The pick is in. A.J. Terrell. I knew it was going to be A.J. Terrell.
I mean, they had no cornerbacks, but I was just putting it out there. They had no cornerbacks. They had a cornerback.
My boy Jamar, shout out to you, man. He's an Atlanta Falcons fan. He called it early. He said if they don't get A.J. Terrell, he's going to be pissed. That's who he wanted. He's from Atlanta, too, so that might be trouble for him.
I'm about to say, that ain't always a good thing.
Right. So you're right, DJ. You called this, man. You said it could be a run on corners, man.
Yeah.
Because I think the Cowboys.
I think if I go back to our mock, I think I'm – no, I got CJ here. But, I mean, we've been saying corner for, you know, Atlanta for a while. Because they lost, you know, Trufant.
Right. From him.
A.J. Terrell, hell of a player with Clemson. Good man-to-man corner. I think he's, what, about 6'1", 6', somewhere around there?
Yeah. And we had him in the mock, if I'm not mistaken. Didn't we have him? But I think it was like
no, more. C.J. Henderson got down to him. That's why, I may mention the C.J. because I think they definitely would have wanted C.J.
I think
Terrell is a good player, really good player.
I think in our mock we may have done maybe like second round or something. I don't know. But I thought he struggled against LSU. So, but everybody almost did against.
Right.
So, let's go. Let's go. I want to see your picks for Atlanta, man. I mean, our picks are mock. Oh, you had Diggs. That's what we had. We had Diggs and we had Kinlaw. But Kinlaw went before them. Jerry, what is Jerry going to do?
Yeah, we're going to stay off of this one.
So, we're going to go ahead
and do
that for the rest of the NFL because that's what they want to talk about. Forget that. We ain't talking about no Cowboys on here. So, we will definitely make sure y'all get a little taste of the Saints. And that'll complete the NFC South first round draft picks. And then we'll can
come
get
back to review
first
round and how we like the way the board fell.
Right.
Maybe what our best player was, our favorite player drafted in the first round was.
Absolutely. So be tuned.
Yeah. To the end. Coming down the stretch of the first round. Here we go.
Them New Orleans Saints.
We just watched the Sorry, New Orleans Saints. I just got jumped in front of for Kenneth Murray. I mocked him to y'all because I really felt like that was the pick. That's why they came up and got him. Who came and got him? I forgot already.
The Los
Angeles. Came up and got him?
The Chargers. Los Angeles. The
Chargers. That might as well get Jordan Love, man.
Hey, man, Patrick Queen's still out there. That's why I had him getting an LSU linebacker. You know, played in the area. You know, you already got fans there. So, that's still an option. But, yeah, we can do a brief. Talk about some of these draft picks. So, last pick was the Atlanta Falcons who got A.J. Terrell. So, I don't even want to say this, but the Dallas Cowboys got CeeDee Lamb. Miami Dolphins got Austin Jackson, tackle from USC. Damian Arnett, from cornerback from Ohio State, went to Las Vegas Raiders. Taysom went to the Jags, man. So, for them to get C.J. Henderson, that's a great first round for what they need. So, Jalen Reagor went to the Eagles. Justin Jefferson went to the Vikings. And, of course, we mentioned already the L.A. Chargers got Kenneth Murray. So,
a lot on the board still. A lot.
Yeah, so the Saints are on the board, and it's a lot. Like I say, they say the best available according to the grades, as you see on the video. DeAndre Swift, Patrick Queen, and DJ's boy, Zach Bond. I like him a lot.
Yeah, I'll show you a little something next.
Yeah, man, you can put me on him. I like him a lot. But it's saying their top – oh, no, this is the Vikings. My bad. I don't know why I clicked on the Vikings. But – there we go. They say the Saints' top need – well, hell, it was the same as the Vikings, corner and linebacker. Jordan Love's going here?
You know, you've already got a home
team. What? Shoot, these dudes ain't always right, I'll tell you that much.
What's your thoughts? Because they got Jeff Gladden, the corner from TCU, the top-rated corner. You got Patrick Queen, the top-rated linebacker. So you got a couple guys you can really get here. Or do you go Jordan Love? It's tough.
Saints don't have a second round pick.
Not right, and they don't have a second round pick. You right, bro.
So whatever this pick is, they better make it worth it.
Right. And I don't know how they wiggle their way into the second round. I don't think that's an option.
Nah, they're just stuck. They're literally stuck. I mean, it is what it is, kind of, this year for the Saints.
So, there's some guys out here, though, man. It's some guys. This is tough. I would hate to be the New Orleans Saints right now. I wouldn't want
to. Do you go for the future, or do you just add another piece to play right now? That's the question right now.
So, it looks like right now, on their defense, every position is slated to a starter already. Just looking at their roster, their team is made out for starters. They're not like my team. We got to draft players to have somebody start. Their team is already laid out defensively. So, that's tough. I mean, ideally,
they want to trade this pick.
You think they want to trade this pick?
I think they would want, because they want to pick up some more picks. I mean, they don't have a lot. They have, what, 5 picks? This,
right.
I think they want to move. Queen's a nice player. I think.
You don't like Queen.
It's not that I don't like Queen.
You're not eye on.
I think he's a second round talent. Being the top of the first round is basically like being the second round. So,
right.
It's in the right area for him. I just think if you have one first round pick,
right.
Drew Brees almost out the door. Teddy Bridgewater's gone. I mean,
Taysom Hill hasn't signed yet.
Right. So, I mean, if and Sean Payton wants to mold somebody to be the heir of Brees where he can move forward. You know what I'm saying? He ain't trying to, because they still have a relatively young team.
Right.
So you're not going to want to wait till next year to get your quarterback, even though there's a really good quarterback coming up next year. You need somebody that can play right now. And if you draft Jordan Love in the first round, you got a quarterback for the next 5 years. So.
Right.
Lewis Riddick, what do you think?
Right. Shout out to Sean Payton for having some Twizzlers on his desk or table, whatever. A very good snack. Me and my baby, the only ones that eat Twizzlers, man. They were like, how you eat that mess? I know it's a sidebar, man, but still. Twizzlers. Give us a check. Hey. Ooh. The pick is in. Let's see who they get. Yo, they got a center. They got the center, Cesar Ruiz. Oh, Cesar Ruiz.
Wow.
I did not see that coming.
Wow.
Well,
that is his preference. He would do that process with a very, very heavy heart. Who you don't see in the picture there, you got Ruiz. Hey, his father. Bruh, Cesar, am I watching Kyler running low too? Let's see. I can
talk about. But it's about. Cesar Ruiz, pick center. I'll tell you about him. That boy, he's nice, but I didn't expect this for them. Definitely a mauler. He's definitely like the best interior lineman in this draft.
Right.
His father was 26.
Yeah. I mean, overall, a good pick. I'll say that. And they got one pick, and you're making your pick here. You ain't picking again until the third round. So this is a win now move. Bolstering that interior of that line for Drew Brees. You gotta look at it that way.
Man, he said he wanted to play center, but he would play wherever they want him to play. Of course you would, my G.
I thought he was more of a guard.
Right. It's a heck of a story, man. I heard about it, somebody, DJ, you something you can relate to, not to bring up memories, but it's a testimony for you. But, he lost his father. But his father was only 26, though. He got, I guess changing the time, somebody. That's got to be tough, man, to deal with. Probably was his motivation, all kind of stuff. So. I think you got a good pick here, man. I know it's not sexy.
Right, I was about to say the same thing.
Oh, well, go ahead.
I would be a lot of people to be upset. I feel like they will. Unless, like I said, we want to talk to our boy TJ. We're going to come back with another show. Definitely want to get his take on this one. Being the Saints fan. But from outside looking in, if Drew Brees wants to continue to play, it's really got the best interior player in the draft. So,
right. It's,
remember back in their heyday,
But that's why the Saints are the same. Let's not – I will give them credit. I didn't like the Davenport move. I still don't like the Davenport move. But for the most part, they drafted pretty well, man. Really well.
They move by their own drum and say they don't do what people think they're going to do.
Right.
You got to give them the rule, so.
And whatever they do, they stick into it, and they've had a lot of success doing it. So I ain't going to question them. I think when you like when you break it down and think about it, I know he's a center, but like you said, are the best interior. Would you say he's the best interior offensive lineman in this draft?
I do. I think he can play guard. I think that because they got a decent center. They have a young center there.
Right.
He's only been there for like 2 years, if I'm not mistaken. I can't remember his name. He's definitely going to play guard. He's not going to play center unless they're thinking about moving the center to guard. But they're both in the middle. I mean, this is Saint football. Block in the middle. Your tackles. I mean, you got two of the best tackles right now. That offensive line is the best in the South. I mean,
right.
You know, it's one of the best in the NFL. I mean, it makes sense. You got to protect Drew Brees.
Right.
You got to continue to protect them. I mean, defense is preset. That's why I thought Jordan Love was a real thing because they're pretty set on both sides of the ball. So, you know, guard, I wouldn't be surprised, you know, after losing some of the players they did in the interior, they're probably not the strongest. But you probably don't realize it because they run such a good scheme that they block it pretty well.
Mm-hmm.
But, I mean, it makes sense. I can't wait to see what TJ going to say. I think it makes sense.
Yeah. I agree, man. When you look at this roster, yes, you have, like, I want to say sexier players that you could have gone that's still on the board. But everywhere I look on the defensive side of the ball, they have a starter already in place. Like, in every position. So they're good. Offensively, it's the same way. They went and got Emmanuel Sanders, so they added another receiver to go with Michael Thomas. They got Jared Cook. You got Drew Brees, Alvin Kamara, Latavius Murray. You have everything, your offensive line. Let's not forget all them all pros you got up there. They're already – this gives them more depth. And like we always say, you win in the what? In the trenches. So, once again – I know they might not like it, but exactly. Dang.
Yeah, man. We appreciate y'all checking out our video. Definitely look out. We're probably going to do a little bit of review on the first round, maybe even give our takes on the second. Saints don't have a second round pick. But yeah, man. Give our little bit of and thanks for coming up again. Checking us out. It's your boy DJ. Follow me on Twitter. DJ Hot. Trying to get a little followers. I'm getting a lot of Facebook ads too. Appreciate y'all on that too. I'm getting a lot of buzz. I'm starting to get a couple other fans too. I got a Panther fan, Saints fan. So shout out to y'all, man, for trying to hit me up, man. Appreciate y'all for start talking. Hit me up, man. I'm probably gonna start posting on my page a little more too. But like, I got a lot of football people now, so you know, I might start posting a little more on my page now.
Right. So, man, yeah, man, it's your boy Mike Ricks, man. Had a great time doing this first round draft, DJ, man. Thank y'all for sticking around, checking it out, seeing our reactions to the picks. I don't want to give a lot away because we still may come back with another video, all three of us talking about the draft. And so, but make sure to like, subscribe, share everything DJ already said, man. You can follow me at Mr. Ricks 07, I believe, on Twitter. I'm sounding like DJ now. DJ used to couldn't get his Twitter name out. Now it's me. I can't remember.
You know, dog.
But still, though, man. Right. But thank y'all for rocking, man. Panther Nation, keep pounding. This is a good pick for us. Moving in the right direction, man. This is a guy that's an instant starter for us. So, hey, be happy with the pick. Hey, man, be blessed. We out.